Good morning to everybody. It's a pleasure for me to introduce you Professor Meo. He is a trustee of the Nexus Center for Internet and Society, and he was professor here at Polytechnic of Turin in computer science. He published more than 100 papers on computer science, and he was head of many projects related to computer science. In 2002, he was head of a commission wanted by the Italian government to promote open software in the public administration. So in this lecture, we will talk about the progresses of ICT and the implications on our society, and also some interesting applications. So thank you, Professor Meo, for coming here.
Thank you to you for this presentation. Chapter 1, the progress of technologies for information processing and communication. For the sake of brevity, I will restrict myself to the last 30 years. Why the last 30 years? Because these are the years in which Internet increased its development in Italy. First, the size of a transistor. In 1986, the transistor was large and high, as 1.5 micrometers. In 2016, the size of the transistor was reduced to 11 nanometers, which is more than a ratio equal to 100. The transistor has become 100 times smaller. Since the transistor, when it becomes more strict, it becomes also more low. When the size is reduced by a factor of 100, the number of transistors which can be embedded on one chip increases by a factor of 100 by 100. That means 10,000. These are two examples, two microprocessors. The first is of the year 1986, 2,000 transistors. At the right, you see a transistor of the last generation, some billions of transistors in the chip, which is an increment superior to the factor of 10,000. When the transistor becomes smaller by a factor of 100, its speed increases by a factor of 100, because the roots which the carrier must describe in order to make it possible to work the transistor, the size is reduced by a factor of 100. So the total processing capability of a chip has increased by a factor of 100 by 100 by 100, equal 1 million. Here we see an example. The number of transistors per chip is today 32,000 times larger. We see two examples, 200,000 transistors in 1986, and some billions of transistors in 2016. But the computational speed is of the order of 8 million. We have made a rough computation equal to 1 million, but since the transistor becomes slightly smaller than 100 in 30 years, the computation speed has increased 8 million times. Also, the technologies of communications have increased their capabilities in this period. This is an example. A pearl of the last generation, an optical fiber. An optical fiber of the last generation, of the size of 10 micrometers, which means 1/100 smaller than a millimeter, of the cost of 2 cents of dollar per meter, is able to transmit without retransmissions intermediate at a distance of 1,000 kilometers, a volume of data of the order of 10 terabits per second, which means 10,000 billions of bits per second, which is of the order of magnitude of the total telephone mondial traffic. That means that the fiber opticals can transmit enormous data in very, very small times. This technological progress has given rise to a number of innovational products. Now, nearly every product which lives near us is endowed of a small microprocessor. We go from the washing machine to the airplane of the last generation. In order to understand the volume, the total volume of the use of information processing technologies, I have made this slide. In our planet, now, about 10 to 10, in reality slightly less, 10 to 10 persons are living, men or women. For every man or woman who is living in this planet, are also living 1,500,000 ants. I have taken this number from a site of internet. I don't know whether it is real, but in my house, about 10 to 7 ants are living, contrasted by my wife, which uses also chemical weapon of mass destruction, but with a little success. Well, for any ant living in this planet are living more than 10 transistors. That means that for every man or woman living in our planet, 10 to 10 millions, about 10 millions of transistors are also living with us. Chapter 2. The dream of Brandt, Schreiber, Mitsubishi, Pichai, 1980. Brandt, we don't have here. Brandt, of course, the head of a team in charge by McNamara, which was then the head of the World Bank. McNamara gave this task of which we are going to speak to Willy Brandt. That team, the team of Willy Brandt, produces a report which has similar conclusions as these other reports. The report to the Club of Paris. This work was done by Jean-Jacques Schreiber, and others, Carl Schiffer, and so on. Jean-Jacques Schreiber was known for a book of 10 years before, devoted to, in Italian, La Sfida. How can we translate the Sfida in English?
The challenge. The challenge.
The challenge. It is not so. The challenge. The American challenge. But after the work presented to the Club of Paris, he modified his conclusions with a new book, The World Challenge. Which agrees perfectly with the report of the team of Willy Brandt. And in Japan, Mitsubishi Memorial. And also the report to the Club of Rome, whose head was Pichai. All these reports arrived to the same conclusion, which is this: the advent of information technology components is prepared a new revolution. Since the cost of an information processing product, since the cost is not based on energy of material, but is made only of intelligence, development of information processing systems is suitable to the poor people as well as to the rich people. In those years, other reports have stated that the distance between rich countries and poor countries had increased. They concluded that there was the opportunity of overcoming this difficulty. In about this year, I don't remember, probably in 1986, I made the prolusione, we say in Italian, the first lecture when a new academic year is inaugurated. There was the Minister of the Public Instruction, public, which was a woman also there, then, and the persons of power in this country, and so on, many, many colleagues. And I presented the results of a progetto finalizzato informatica, a national research project on informatics, which I had directed. And at the conclusion, has arrived to the same analysis made by Willy Brandt, Jean-Jacques Scriabin, and so on. So I closed my lecture with a slide which is exactly the one that I am presenting you now. It was written by hand on a paper for the blackboard that you probably remember. No, probably you not remember that blackboard since you are too young. But the semantics of that slide was exactly this. In that slide, I presented what I thought to be possible future of mankind, of our country in particular, in the following years. And you see the Esquimese works for IBM, which is owned by Olivetti, the American person. Controllo la contabilità della DEA. I am working on the economical data of DEA. DEA was a company which produced splendid products, which were devices finalized to analyze the three-dimensional form of a surface in the space, useful above all in order to evaluate a car, the side of a car. And finally, the Chinese programma il pilota automatico per l'ultimo modello della Fiat. I am working for the automatic pilot for the last moment of the field. There has that. There now is a building absolutely void, which is the dream of many builders of buildings. Olivetti is dead. Fiat is no more Fiat. It's called FCA. Its main city is not Turin, but in another country. And the center of gravity of its activities are in the Atlantic, more near to Detroit than to Detroit. We hope. I prefer not to speak of the chief of FCA, since I still hope to win the Formula One Championship. I do not want that you think that I, in Italian, apologizing with the lady. Is she Italian? The lady in this room?
Italiana.
Is she Italian?
Yeah.
I don't want you think that I porto sfiga. Sfiga is not a word to be used in a city like this, above all in presence of a lady. But now Pope Francesco has made free the use of this word. Indeed, 15 days ago, he answered to somebody which gave this birthday 4 days before the exact days of the birthday, told to speak of the birthdays 4 days before, porta sfiga. So this word can be freely used also in a context like this one. But the real sfiga, however, the semantics of word sfiga, Umberto Eco would say, is much, much stronger than the semantic of the word sfortuna. Well, I am not the responsible of the sfiga, of the Italian sfiga. The responsible is the dominant culture, economic culture, in our country. I have collected a long sequence of sentences of stars of first magnitude in the sea of the power in our country, economists, managers, and so on, politicians, which prove that the real sfiga was the dominating opinion of those persons. If you are interested, privately, I will send this slide to you, if you ask. Well, the dream of 1986 has not come true. The records of Ocean reveal that not only the distance between rich countries and poor countries has increased, but also the difference between the richness, the power of a rich man and poor man who are living together in the rich countries, have increased. Why the dream did not come true? For two reasons. Because of the market and because of the devil. Why the devil? The answer arrives in other times to the Pope Francesco. Francesco stated that the devil is capitalism. And this is one of the theses of my talk now. But let us remain on the faults of the market. Why the market is against the dream of Willy Brandt? For two reasons. First reason. First, the economy of scale of information products with respect to the size of the product. For example, the cost of a software packet of 1,000 lines is 4 times smaller than the cost of a product of 2,000 lines. If I spend for the first product 10,000 dollars, I must spend $40,000 for this product. The cost increases according to some researches with the number, the size, cost equal to size two. That means that this is not an economy of scale, but a diseconomy of scale with size. But with respect to the market, the information processing systems are characterized by strong, very strong economy of scales. Cost, number of copies, if I spend $1 million in order to produce a software system, and I can send only one copy of that product, I must sell that product at the price of $1 million. But if I am able to sell 1 million copies, then I can sell the product at a cost of $1. This is a factor which makes more easy the life to the big competitors with the small competitors. Have I been clear? Stop me in any moment that I am not clear, please. The devil is appears already here. See, these are the laws of the market. All this is based on a basic theorem. The theorem of one of the basic theorems of capitalism. The property right, the laws of property rights. I think that the future of mankind can increase only when the property rights will be cancelled at all. Property rights, above all, patents. Have no meaning, no values today. All inventions now are my inventions. Why? Because the knowledge has increased with an exponential law. So any new idea is a copy of hundreds of preceding ideas. It is impossible to invent something new. But the operator strong used this rules in order to cancel, to better the poor. These are some examples. The toasting has been patented, not a specific toaster, the toasting, the concept of toasting. The one click, this is a patent. If you work on a site in order to buy something, and at the end to take the decision of buying something, if you express this decision with one click, this is not allowed since a patent. Has been issued on the topic. So, some months later, arrived the patent of two clicks. There is space, if you want, for a patent of three clicks. I have tried to find in Google a patent of three clicks is not should at least. And then a shot of golf has been patented. And the shape of the arm in shooting the ball. If you want to convince yourself of my opinion, make this experiment. Also immediately, go to Google and state patent and then a word chosen randomly. And you see how many patents you will find. The patents are today tens of millions and tens of millions. This is an example. The patents relative to dogs. These are only for example, for this slide. At the right, in the right, you see the clock for dogs. The idea is that since dogs live 7 times less than we, than us, then the clock for dogs must go 10 times quicker. But it is a stupid idea, since they go to bed exactly at midnight as we do. Then you see a device to transfer dogs, an umbrella for dogs, and a device for combating ants and so on. This is another example. Toilet buttons. At the right, in the high section, you see an escalier which makes it possible to dogs and cats to go upstairs and use the toilet of the man. Then you see a toilet to be attached to the car, a toilet in the car, and at the left in the high section, an authentic invention of high value, a high value concept. It is a device which has been designed in order to avoid that men, not women, men, when they piss, go outside of the perimeter of the bottle. It is based on a bidimensional array that you see, and a suitable product of artificial intelligence identified the center of gravity of the jet. And when the jet goes near to the perimeter, a slide on the screen invites the person to correct the jet. These are examples in order to enjoy ourselves, but the patents which protect Apple with respect to the Asian competitors, as the patent which protect the Asian competitor with respect to Apple, and the American courts decided a way, the Asian courts decided exactly opposite. Stupid as those examples which I show here. For example, the phone of the this device has been patented by Apple and so on. Chapter 3, the new applications. Indeed, in the last 4 or 5 years, a number of new applications have been proposed, very, very important, and with very, very strong implications in the market, in our lives, in the economy. First example, the super paint of Professor Lambicchi. You are too young, and so you cannot understand this slide. Super paint of Professor Lambicchi has been proposed in a slide of the Corriere dei Piccoli when I was a child. I am speaking of the years 40 of the century before this one. which was the specification of this super paint. This super paint used on the images, on the photographs, on the designs, had the ability to make real those figures. For example, from the window of my room, I saw a disciple on a tablet before my room. My dream was to obtain a bottle of super paint, go in the light and use that disciple in order to produce a real disciple. Later, a few years later, I had a dream of the same type, having as object not the production of bicycles, of cars, but of other things. But fortunately, the other dream, I think, I am certain, will not be available in the future of Homo sapiens. Absolutely in many, many centuries, and centuries of centuries. The automatic production of girls is outside of the possibility of mankind. It is possible, but the time of production of the order of 18 years, which are not compatible with the needs of the market. But the immediate production is not possible in the future. Which is the super paint born a few years ago? Is the three-dimensional printer. The three-dimensional printer is a device which accepts in input the analytical design of the shape of a product and transforms that design into a real product. It is a tool of basic importance, not in the production of the goods, but in the production of the prototypes, which will become production in line, specifically line. The well-known, probably the most known International Review of Economics has devoted its cover to the three-dimensional printer with exactly this image. You see a person which works on his personal computer, and from the personal computers will derive airplanes, cars, and so on. The title of the car was The Third Industrial Revolution. But now we are already at the fourth industrial revolution. We shall know what I mean in a few slides. However, as an anticipation, the fourth industrial revolution is a symbol in the fabric 4.0. Another important revolution, Internet of Things. You see an example, Internet of Things in our house. However, the general idea of Internet of Things is this: any object will have its CPU, its memory, its set of sensors and actuators, and his address of internet. So it will be able to transmit to other sensors, other Twitter, other systems, the results of its processing. For example, if I decide the hour of tomorrow morning in which I must stop sleeping at 8 o'clock, operating the sound, which will be the music loved by the user. One hour before, it will send a message to the washer, the scaldabagno. And 20 minutes before, to the toaster, it will be the same, in order to make it possible to synchronize exactly all the activity of that moment. More important, the applications to health care of the Internet of Things. I have forgotten in my room, but I have a number of prototypes developed in this Politecnico. The nine prototypes have been made by Eros Pasero, which is a colleague of mine, which makes it possible at very low cost to measure the pressure of blood, the electrocardiogram, the electroencephalogram, the glycemic, and so on. All these elementary subsystems will be connected through internet in order to make it possible to analyze in detail the states of my health and transmit the related data to the doctor or to the analysis laboratory. This is seen with favor. This invention makes happy not only the persons interested, but also the Minister of Health, since he is hoping to reduce the cost of health. And the factory 4.0, the first revolution, which has a number of complex implications. We see, for example, the implication on collaborative robotics with cloud computing, cyber physical systems, big data. The question of big data is of basic importance today. In every day, now, we produce as many data as have been produced in 5 centuries of printed of printing. Data are bigger, always bigger. So it is necessary to invent new solutions in order to analyze this data. These solutions are generally called as artificial intelligence. The artificial intelligence is not the real tool used, but complex mathematical algorithm based, for example, on data mining, on complex data mining algorithms are used today in order to analyze big data. In any moment of the activity of the factory, 4.0. And this slide summarizes the programs which have been decided in these years. They are referring to the situation of 2020. In 2020, if the project in this moment activated remote, we should have 4 billion of connected people. 4 trillion, the American trillions are not the, the Italian trillions. The trillions are migliaia di miliardi. So the trillions, i miliardi sono billions. I nostri billions sono le miliardi e miliardi in Italia. Invece negli Stati Uniti i billions sono i miliardi. I trillions sono le migliaia di miliardi. Mentre per noi invece sono le migliaia di billion. 4 trillions in the American sense, the opportunities of revenues, more than 25 million of new applications, more than 25 billion of embedded and intelligent systems, and above all, 50 trillion of gigabytes of data. Gigabytes of data. I repeat this data. Gigabytes. Chapter 4. My thesis here is this. The new application of which I have just spoken a few minutes ago says the super paint of Professor Lambicchi to the factory 4.0 transform the situation and open new important opportunities. New opportunity in the sense which was the dream by Willy Brandt. I have reported here only quickly simple example. Example number one, the explosion of free software. There is a site specialized in collecting and distributing free software. SourceForge, 2 years ago, and this data are old of 2 years ago, stated with the tools we provide, 2 million developers create powerful software in over 260,000 projects. This data are old. Now, according to some other site, SourceForge has 5 million of developers, 5 million of developers, working on 1/10, 10 developer for any different project. Our popular directory connects more than 46 million consumers with this open source project and serves more than 2 million downloads a day. SourceForge is where open source happens. This is a real revolution. We have not understood the importance of resources, since we also closing our debates on Windows, Linux, and so on. But the process is very, very, very long and very, very important, the new projects. Another example, a set of proposals in order to make it possible that poor countries build houses, simple houses, with tools specifically designed, but simple tools of low cost. A set of 50 tools / technologies for building post-scarcity resilient communities, above all, houses. And this is an example of this open, these are open tools. Another example, a third example. 1,000 years after the death of the first king of Italy, we are speaking of King Arduino. He was the king of a very small kingdom, but the first king which had been called the King of Italy. His name was King Arduino. In Ivrea, there is a bar. They wanted to Arduino, King of Italy. You don't see, but there, Arduino, King of Italy. And in that bar, 5 young scientists and teachers developed an architecture, a simple architecture, for processing data, for realizing cheap personal computers to use in the schools. Those young scientists invented Arduino. The real important idea was to make free their design. Every person can copy the design in order to produce new personal computers, new sensor, actuator, video chambers, and so on, using the data of the design. In this moment, millions of pieces of hardware Arduino have been produced and sold in all the world. An example. One day, two students of mine came to me and asked me the thesis. I have just received a telephone call from the chief, the president of the National Union of Deaf, Czech. And he gave me the problem of the World Championship of Sfiga, the blind deaf, those persons who do not see and do not hear. And I gave them this problem. And I proposed a solution, which has been suggested to me by the president of the association, of using an international code which attributes to part of the hand to characters of the alphabet and so on. They disappeared 3 months ago, having decided not to use the idea that I had proposed to them, but to use the language of signs. You know which is the language of signs? That language which I used, adopted by those very clever women, generally women, which translate the data given by television with sounds. I remember this. The strike of the controllers of lights, and so on. A variant of that language is used working on the hands of the deaf blind. In this way, the same language with suitable transformation becomes the language used in this. So my two students started a new project which was called which is the name?
Parluma.
No?
Parluma.
Parlum. Because it is in dialect of Turing, Parluma. Parluma. Which has obtained a great success. And do you see the scheme? Sign receiving from the network. The hand is controlled by a series of commands. And motion and the reproduction of the sign. Well, these my students needed in order to implement the automatic lecture, the automatic transmission of information from the network or between persons, a robotic arm. But a robotic arm costed 300 euros. And so they designed the robotic arm, went to a lab farm lab, and with the three-dimensional printer, printed the small pieces of the robotic arm, and they arrived to me with the robotic arm already operating. This is an example of how the world is changing. 10 years ago, a solution like this was impossible with the exception of big companies. Now, two persons, very clever, but true, have been able to realize a very complex technological solutions. And I close with market operations in favor of myself. And I think that it is allowed to me to make this market operation since I do not gain any sense from this activity. Since 18 years, a small team of small scientist teachers of schools, primary schools and secondary schools, are working with the Scuola in Ospedale, Hospital School, with two objectives: to learn learning objects suitable to the needs of the students, and to realize technologies which reach to make remote lectures from the room to the house of the student, the house of the hospital. Now prevalent the house, since above all the oncological students are, in Italian, immunodepressed. So they must remain in the hospital the less time is possible. In 2012, 5 years ago, we discovered that what we had produced might be useful not only for the school, for ill students, but also for all the schools. And so we realized a portale called FARE, as Free Architecture for Remote Education. I take the liberty of inviting you to visit that portale at the address fare.polito.it. In this moment, FARE is a big archive which contains more than 250 videos of important scientific lectures, many books, free books, and learning objects of mathematics, physics, science, Latin, biology for schools, some books on computer science, everything absolutely free, comprised the textbooks. I know that the industrial man of production of books is not happy. Indeed, the industrial cost of a book for schools is of the order of 1 or 2 euros, but it is sold at 10-15 euros. These books are absolutely free. All the needs of scientific disciplines, biology and so on, are available in our archive. We have a number of educational video games. We can find them in fare.polito.it/gioco. The future is multifare, in the sense that all the software which has been developed by us is absolutely free, so it can be copied and other cards can be implemented, and all of this will be transparent. So from Turing I will be able to analyze and possibly download the content of the fare of the web. Besides, we have developed the tools which make it possible to the teacher to combine learning objects of fare with other learning objects in order to realize a personalized copy of the lecture, of the book, and so on. Then we have embedded in FARE the remote lecture. The main objective is represented by the needs of the Yale students, of course, but it can be used in any school. Since now, 200 schools in our region will be able to transmit the lectures to the Yale students using FARE. Typical application, the remote laboratory. This is the prototype realized in the laboratory called in the foundation school called I don't remember il laboratorio perché il laboratorio perché nel laboratorio perché we have installed some video cameras and so the students from his bed will be able to verify the results of the program that he has written in real time on the basis of this system of transmission. Then we have realized a line of tools finalized to produce new MOOCs. Do you know which are the new MOOCs?
MOOCs means Massive Open Online Courseware.
The market of MOOCs has exploded in the last 3 years. In all the countries, even if generally the MOOCs which are proposed on the market are simply MOOCs, in the sense they have chosen the open. But we have realized the tools to realize really MOOCs open. And in the national competition called Talent Italy, promoted by the Ministry of Education, our solution was well accepted and positively judged, and so we have been the second runner. In virtue not of the quality of our MOOCs, which were not real MOOCs but simply Vitellini, and not MOOC ma Vitellini, but in virtue of the idea of the tools which make it possible to realize the new MOOCs. So we arrived to the conclusion. In the new framework, worldwide framework, characterized by millions and millions of ideas, new products, and so on, the first chapter of the DEVIL, according to which development is based on competition, is no more true. Why? It doesn't make sense that many, many different companies, persons, realize the same things. It is not a company by definition. The real future will be based at least we hope, it will be based on cooperation. And probably this time, perhaps, now we hope that in the future, the devil will not be again. Exactly 3:30. Any questions? Too difficult. If some of you want to collaborate in the realizing new ideas, we have new ideas to be developed. The basic idea is, however, everything absolutely free. I thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.